If you're wondering what all the cheering is about, it's because Jeff Kinney has just produced something all these kids have been waiting for. The 9th book in his mega-selling Diary of a Wimpy Kid series. This one's called The Long Haul. This is kind of a nightmare family road trip. Is that how you describe it?
I think every family road trip of more than about 3 hours is a nightmare family road trip. And you know, I think that I got the cover image just right, which is Greg in the way back of the minivan under a pile of luggage. Every time I show that to kids, they say, that's me, I've been there.
Greg is Greg Heffley, perpetually stuck in middle school, as he puts it, with a bunch of morons. He's always being embarrassed by his parents, and he's got two awful brothers, a nasty older one, and a tattletale toddler. Then there's Greg, who is a very nervous and sort of sneaky and fearful, bullied and bullying protagonist, right?
That's right.
I mean, why have someone as a main character who's not the least bit heroic?
When I was writing Diary of a Wimpy Kid, I was actually reading Harry Potter. He's brave, he's magical, he's powerful. And I wasn't any of these things as a kid. So I wanted to create a character who was more like I was.
Were you a wimpy kid?
I was a kid who was an average kid, but I had very wimpy moments.
Jeff Kinney grew up outside Washington, D.C., dreaming of becoming a cartoonist. He actually created a successful comic strip for the University of Maryland's campus newspaper. But when he tried to land a cartooning job after graduation,
I went through about 3 years of sending out submissions and then getting rejected. So it was really kind of soul crushing.
Then he got a day job designing online games. On the side, he started writing and illustrating Diary of a Wimpy Kid. But it wasn't for kids.
In fact, the first draft was 1,300 pages long, and it was meant to be sort of a primer or a nostalgia piece for adults.
He worked on that draft for 8 years. Why didn't you give up?
Because I was prolonging the rejection in a way. Part of it was just, putting off the inevitable for me.
Still, in 2006, at a comic book convention, he showed a short excerpt to an editor from Abrams Books, mostly known for its elegant volumes on art.
And then he just looked at the first page. He didn't read anything at all. And he said, this is exactly what we're looking for, and this is why we're here. And then he said, and it's going to be for kids. And believe it or not, that was a huge shocker to me at the time. Never for a second in the 8 years I was working on Diary of a Wimpy Kid did I think that I was writing for kids.
One, two, three.
But when the Wimpy Kid was marketed to a young audience, it took off beyond Jeff Kinney's wildest dreams.
I'll never forget when the New York Times list came out and I had made the list and I couldn't believe it. My wife and I were jumping up and down on the bed, and in fact it stayed on the list for more than 5 years straight. And I pinch myself every day.
It was surprising. It's still surprising to us. Every now and then we're like, how did this happen? Like, why did it happen? This is nuts.
Nuts or not, Jeff's wife Julie and sons Will and Grant seem to take it all in stride. Even the fact that Jeff has been an executive producer of 3 films based on the series.
Let me get something straight. This is a journal, not a diary.
To stay close to his readers, Jeff Kinney travels all over the country, turning up at places like Edward Mullen School in Newburyport, Massachusetts, where everyone seems to be a fan.
Just raise your hands if you like the Diary of a Wimpy Kid books. Yeah? What do you like about the books?
I can't stop reading them. Like, I read them over and over all the time.
It's just so funny and interesting. You never know what's going to happen next.
But some adults have been critical of Kinney's simple drawings and writing style. The books have even been likened to literary junk food.
It's kind of a combination of huge compliments and very almost angry insults
about
the book.
Yeah. I think what most parents and teachers have come to understand is that my books are good gateway reading, is that they're not the books you want your kids to end up reading, but they're a great way to get them started. And I'm very comfortable with that.
And it's hard to argue with success. There are more than 150 million copies of his books in print, making the author a very rich man.
So this has been about 5 years in the making.
So what's he doing with his earnings? Well, see what's going on in his adopted hometown of Plainville, Massachusetts.
Well, there used to be a decrepit market in the middle of town, a general store, and it was falling apart.
So Kinney is building something new here.
There's going to be a bookstore, a cafe slash coffee shop. We're going to have a big function space for people to do community and cultural events.
In fact, Jeff Kinney is calling the bookstore
an unlikely story.
Because that is what his own story has been. And he still can't quite believe it's true.
This boy has a letter for you.
Oh, nice. Thank you so much.
He claims he still feels like a failed cartoonist.
I will always admire the real cartoonist for cracking that nut, and I couldn't do it myself.
Does the huge pile of money that you make make up for any of this?
Well, I feel lucky that I didn't get the dream. I was denied the dream I went after, because I think this is a better dream, so I'm going to hold on to that.
Thanks, God. Thank you. Thanks, God.
You're my hero.
You're my hero, bud. Thank you.